Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of .NET, that is .NET version 9 on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a simple console application using this latest version of .NET. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'll definitely going to help you. So now to install latest version of .NET, you have to first simply go to favorite browser, and then you have to just simply type over here .NET SDK download and hit enter. So that's going to show you this .net.microsoft.com as a first search result. So to click on this download.net, and when you click on that, it's going to automatically redirect to the official site of Microsoft. So this link I'm going to provide right in your description. So once when you are here, you will see that currently there are two versions. One is .NET version 9, another is .NET version 8. So I have made a video about .NET version 8 just previously. So you can watch that video as well if you need to download .NET version 8. So that will give you a long-term support. And .NET version 9 is the latest one. So that's going to provide a standard term support. So that is recommended also. So all you need to do is to download, and to just simply click on this download.NET SDK x64. And immediately you will see thanks for downloading and your file is rightly started downloading. So it's just a 213 MB file, so let's wait for some time to get it downloaded. And you can see that our file is rightly downloaded. Let's minimize our browser and go to our download directory. And you can see that our latest version of .NET is rightly downloaded over here. So to install, just simply double click on the installer. And there you go, Microsoft.NET latest version SDK is installation wizard is rightly open. So let's click on install. So it will ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes, and there you go. You can see that our setup is rightly started. So it will take a couple of minutes. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you please to consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel as well. Here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. So if you subscribe both these to our channel, that's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. Alright. And also if you want, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script vlogging channel. So all these channel links I'm going to provide on our description. So here let's wait for a couple of minutes. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our Microsoft.NET version 9 installation was successful. So everything is fine. You can close this, and now if you go to search and just simply type cmd to open your command prompt, and within our command prompt if you just simply type .NET space dash dash info and simply hit enter, you'll be able to see this type of prompt telling you that our latest version of .NET, that is version 9, is successfully installed on our system. So you should be able to see this SDK, .NET SDK version on your command prompt once. So when you type this .NET dash dash, I mean .NET space dash dash info. Alright, so you should be getting this prompt. Once when you get this prompt, then that basically means is your .NET is successfully installed on your system and you are good to go to start working on your .NET projects. So let's close this command prompt and create a new folder on our desktop. So let's name this folder as .NET projects and just go inside that folder. And now just simply click on this address bar and type cmd to open our command prompt right at this folder. So our command prompt is rightly open at this folder. So here using one command you can create your project. I'm going to show you first what are all different projects that you can create on .NET. So for that, just simply type .NET space new list and just simply hit enter. So that's going to show you this entire list. So I'll maximize this. So that's going to show you this entire list that .NET is going to support, entire list of projects that .NET is supporting. So you can see you can create an API controller project or ASP.NET just empty project or web API project, all these things. Or if you want to create a console app, that also you can do. So all you need to do is you need to use the short name. Alright, so let's say you'd like to create a MVC controller project. All you need to do is just corresponding to that the short name, that is MVC controller, is what you need to use. I'm going to show you what command you need to type. Alright, so basically what I'm trying to tell is, like, you can create all these different projects. All you need to do is to use this command. But before that command, what you need to type is .NET space new, and then you need to provide that short name. So let's say you'd like to create a console app. So in that case, you need to use this command called console. Or let's say you want to create just a simple class library project. You need to use this class lib, all right, as a short name. So first you need to type .NET new, and then you need to provide that short name. I'd like to create a console app, so I'll just simply type console, then space, and then we need to use one flag called name, and that flag name will tell us, like, what name that you'd like to give to your project. So let's say we'll give our project name as Hello World. So you should be giving your own project name, and then just simply hit enter. Alright, so that's going to immediately start processing, and it's going to start creating our project. You can see that it is actually created at this location. So within .NET project, it has created a folder called Hello World, and that has our project file, that is csproj. So if you go to our folder, you'll be able to see this Hello World project that we created over here. So if you go inside that, you can see all files and folders over here. So here is our csproj file, and here is our program.cs. So if you open this file on Notepad, you can see here we have the starting code, that is console.writeline hello world, is also written over here. So you can always print this on our console. So just go to your command prompt and just type something like .NET space build and name of our project file, which is helloworld.csproj. So just simply type that same helloworld.csproj and simply hit enter. So that's going to show you this error, because we are in a wrong directory. We need to go inside this folder called Hello World, right? So we are inside only .NET projects. We are not inside Hello World. So you need to first simply type cd, then Hello World. So we need to go inside this folder, and then we need to run this command called .NET build, then name of our project. All right. So hit enter. So immediately we'll see that it is rightly started building. So when it get builded, you'll be able to see a bin folder created over here. So succeeded in 12 seconds. So a bin folder gets created, and it's a debug folder. Go inside .NET version 8, and you will see a exe over here. So now to run this exe, all you need to do is, you need to just simply go inside this debug.NET folder. So just simply type cd, and this is our path. So just copy this path and paste it over here. So cd bin/debug, then .NET version 9, and you can remove this. So just hit enter. So we are inside our debug folder, that is .NET version 9. And now you need to run this exe, hello world.exe. So just simply type hello world.exe, hit enter. So that's going to show you the output hello world on our console. So whatever you have written, so whatever you like to print on our console, so that same output should be coming on your command prompt. Alright, so in this way you install latest version of .NET, that is version 9, on a Windows operating system. So don't forget to subscribe to our Geeky Syntax channel, along with Geeky Script blogging channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.